Good morning, my wonderful students. It's me, Ms. Dim Choma. We are going to look at crop pests. Introduction. Pests attack crops and decrease their production. To greatly affect production, a given pest must be present in large numbers to affect production. And this pest usually destroys crops, and all this destruction causes effects. Before I proceed, at the end of this class, I expect you learners to be able to define crop pests, explain the life cycle of some crop pests, and highlight different methods used to control crop pests. Let's look at the definition. Crop pests are organisms that are capable of causing damage to crop plants. And I want you to also know that a pest may either be plant or animal. Plant pests are known as weeds. Let's look at some crop pests that attack various parts of crop plants. The first one is the stem borers. As name implies, they bore stems. Example we can see is maize stem borers, and you have the image below. Effect of this maize stem borer is that it weakens the stem and causes the maize plant to break at just any slight wind. Life cycle of maize stem borers. The maize stem borers are larvae of certain moths. The moths lay 3,000 to 4,000 eggs on the maize plant. After a week, the egg hatch into larvae which bore into the stem and feed on it, just like what you can see in the diagram displaying on your screen right now. That's the life cycle of the maize stem borer, from the egg hatching to larva to pupa, then to adults, so the adult moths. The second crop pest that attack crop is the root feeders. Example we can see is the yam beetle. The yam beetle live mainly in the soil. Effects: they live round the holes which allow disease infections and cause the tuber of this yam to rot. Most of the time you might have seen yam tubers getting rot. It's mainly caused by this insect pest, which is called the yam beetle. Life cycle of yam beetle. The mature yam beetles breed and lay their eggs in their river banks. They hatch into larvae, which feed at first on decay matter in the soil, and then on grass roots before changing into pupa. The adult beetle emerges and sets off on feeding migration and moves to yam cultivation areas where they burrow into the ground and feed on yam tuber. And this is just a brief of the metamorphosis of the yam beetle. They undergo complete metamorphosis. Egg, larva, pupa, and adults. That is the complete metamorphosis. Hope you can remember the differences between complete and incomplete metamorphosis. Let's proceed. The third one is the leaf feeders. Examples are snails, leaf feeding beetles, grasshopper, locusts, caterpillars of moths, and butterfly. And the effect of these leaf feeders is this. These leaf feeders usually cause disfiguration. They usually feed on you on vegetables. Most of the time, you must have gone to the market with your parents to pick vegetables. It can be your pumpkin leaf, it can be your water leaf, and you realize that this vegetable part, this leafy parts have holes. This is caused mainly by leaf feeders. So therefore, these leaf feeders have actually caused disfiguration on the leaves, and they also weaken the infested plants. The first one is the young shoot feeders. Examples are insects such as aphids, mealybugs, and scales. Effects of young shoot feeders. These young shoot feeders transmit disease-causing fungi, bacteria, and viruses to the plants. Life cycle of cassava mealybug, which is an example of young shoot feeders. Cassava mealybug first settles on the shoot apex and feed on young tissue. Gradually, they move to the leaves and then spread to all parts of the plant. The female lay up to 450 eggs, and the life cycle from the egg to adults. And the life cycle from the life cycle from the egg to adult only take about 23 days. The fruit and the seed feeders. The fruit and the seed feeders, example, the cotton stainers, the fruit piercing moths, fruit flies. You can see a fruit fly is on this orange, feeding on the orange. You can see them on the banana. Fruit flies on banana. And this is how the fruit fly actually look like. And the effect of this fruit fly is they cause fungus disease by injecting spores that contain fungus while feeding on the seed. Control of pests. This pest needs to be controlled. It needs to be controlled to prevent our crops from damage. Part of the control measures are, number one, physical methods. And I also want you to know that pest control is important for the following reasons: to reduce the pest populations and to protect the crop plants. Number one, physical method. This involves collecting pests by using traps and all other physical methods such as burning, picking, scarecrow to keep the pest away. This is trap. You can use this trap to catch mouse. This is a mouse trap. Then this scarecrow. Scarecrow is used to scare birds away from crops such as maize because they love feeding on grains generally. Then chemical method. Chemical method involves the use of pesticides to control pests. This can be applied as dusts, granules, liquids, suspension or emulsion. You can see somebody spraying pesticide on the crops to kill pests. The third one, biological method. This involves the use of natural enemies of pests to control pests. Such enemies may be the predators, parasites, or disease of the pest. For example, talking about predators, you can use cats to chase mouse from a farmland. That's using predators. Then another example is when you use the enemies of the pest, same predators, release of parasitic wasps to control aphids, like you can see in the picture below. Cultural method. The normal farming practices is modified so that environmental conditions do not favor the development of pests. Example is using crop rotation, fallowing, also changing the time of planting. Then the fifth one is modern trends in pest control. By using sterile male technique, male insect pests are sterilized. Sterilization makes them infertile. So male insect pests are sterilized by chemicals or radiation, and they are released into the population. Some chemicals attract insect pests. They are used to lure these pests to come in contact with chemicals, and these chemicals usually cause sterility. Yes, so we've talked about crop pests, various groups of crop pests with examples, also methods of control of crop pests. Let's use this answer this question in the next few minutes. Classwork. Define crop pests. Number two, list the various group of pests that affect crop plants and state two examples of each. Number three, highlight four methods of crop pest control and write short notes on two of the methods you highlighted. Now, this is the assignment to be submitted. Assignment, explain the concept disease. What is a disease? The next one, state different crop disease you know. Thank you for listening and don't forget to subscribe. I remain Ms. Dim Chioma Njoku. Thank you very much.